Hey, it's been for the win. Wizzy, Wizzy, win.
What's happening? And it's Sunny the host.
I try to get him to go along with it.
It's really
it
the game, the Ben shows.
Anyways,
do it again. Do it again. Ben,
No. Oh. Now you threw me off track. This is a Ben show, though. And you're not done with it? And we have a great lineup for you guys today, as always. And we're starting off with something pretty iconic.
Yes, indeed.
35 years of service from the Gay Men's Chorus in Brighton Gayborhood. And Brandon's down there checking it all out. It's a fun festival. They're singing. People are having a good time. Check this out.
Did you get to do your little dance?
Yeah, that's why I was in a singing mood.
Welcome to Gayborhood TV. I'm your host, Brandon, and today we are in the heart of the Gayborhood celebrating 35 years of the Philadelphia Gay Men's Chorus, a group in this community that's near and dear to my heart. Today we're going to get to talk to the president, Adam Funk, about this wonderful celebration that they're having and just exactly what is next in line for the Philadelphia Gay Men's Chorus. Come along. But I need to tell you something. Thank you so much for having us.
I'm thrilled to be here. Thank you for being here.
35 years.
35 amazing years for the Philadelphia Gay Men's Chorus.
Now, for the people who aren't aware back at home about what the Philadelphia Gay Men's Chorus does and how vital it is to our community, tell us a little bit about the mission.
We are a nonprofit organization. Our mission is to entertain audiences and deliver a message of hope and acceptance to the community and the youth of Philadelphia.
And especially the youth. You know, viewers back at home, these guys go into high schools and sing and give hope to young kids. Talk to me a little bit about the outreach program that PGMC does.
So the outreach program unofficially started about 6 years ago. 3 years ago, it got very serious and we created it as a part of our really the nonprofit mission of the organization. We'll go out to 9 to 10 schools a year. We'll perform for the students and then we'll host a little Q&A session where they get to talk to us, ask questions, we get to talk to them. Really, again, about delivering acceptance and hope. So our concert is on June 1st and June 2nd. It's One Hit Wonders. It is a sing-along, so you get to sing along with us, but it is all your favorite One Hit Wonders. So all those songs that you love and you know, but you have no idea who sang them, we're singing all your favorites, and it's going to be an amazing time. It's at the Prince Theater right here in Center City.
The Gay Men's Chorus is so fun. It's so funky. I swear, every time I go to a Gay Men's Chorus concert, I laugh, I cry, I learn some dance moves. Like, you guys do it all, which I very much appreciate. Going out into our community with the schools and working with, and having you see music. And so somebody that saw arts programs cut and arts education and music programs cut for years, it's so important for our youth to have that. So thank you for that. Keep bringing that to them. They don't have those resources, so that's so important that you guys do.
Thank you for joining us today on My New Philly, where something is always new and everything is always Philly. We'll catch you next time.
We were down there in the scene with everyone, talking, interviewing, singing with one of the most and the most iconic and best choruses in the world.
Awesome.
And guess what?
Did you sing?
Yes.
Let me hear you.
La, 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 la.
Well, as you can see, we're not on that choir. Well, also, Philly Close Up got a chance to sit down and preview and talk to Ontaria Kim Wilson and Alexander Rush about Japanese asteroids. It's an amazing film.
Japanese asteroids? Yeah. I can only imagine what that is about.
I'm not gonna go there. Let's look at it.
Welcome to Philly Close Up. When stars come to Philly, we get you close up. And today we are at the Granary with Ontaria Kim Wilson and Alexandra Rush. They are part of this awesome project called Japanese Asteroids. Ladies, welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, thank you
for having us.
Well, Kim, I've had the pleasure of working with you before on a number of projects. You're an awesome choreographer and just a creative mind in general. But tell me a little bit about how you got involved in this project.
So, Tony Moore, who is the creator of Japanese Asteroids, he basically came up with the idea a little over 10 years ago.
Wow.
So he presented it that long ago, and over the years he's been working on it, kind of fine-tuning it, bringing in writers to work with him. And a few months ago, he came to me and he said, listen, I want you on board, but I want to know what you want to do.
Okay.
Do you want to act or do you want to be on the other side?
Yeah, because you definitely do both quite well.
Thank you. So I decided to just be on the production side, assisting him. But that turned into helping to co-write, produce, and now I've taken on the role as the co-director because we're directing together. Okay.
And she's doing an amazing job.
No doubt in my mind. Alexandra, I haven't had the pleasure of meeting you before today, but tell me a little bit about yourself as an actress and how you got involved in the project.
Well, it's very nice to meet you, first off. I got involved because, again, I knew Tony, and I had met him because Anton, a friend of mine, brought me in to see him to sing for him because I'm a singer as well as an actress. And so we seemed to really get along, but we just didn't find a project to work on right then and there. So a couple months later, maybe like 5 months later, I heard from him and he's like, hey, do you remember me? I want you to get involved with this project. I want you to read it. I want you to tell me what characters that you know, relate to, and I want you to get back to me and we'll figure it out and come in an audition. And I was like, okay.
What character do you play?
I play Enigma, and she's a bit of a nerd. More than a bit of a nerd. She's very intelligent and she's a loner, and her intelligence kind of gets in the way a lot of the time, I think, for her. But it also helps a lot in many ways, especially with the mission they kind of go on throughout.
Well, what is the biggest thing you ladies would like the public to know about the story? Because everything that I've read, everyone that I've talked to thus far has said that this is something that the public has not seen yet. This is something completely new. You guys are chartering new territories. So what would you like the public to know about this project?
It deals heavily with mental illness and the trauma that a person experiences throughout a lifetime. And they don't necessarily understand the source of the anxiety or the depression or the nightmares that happen and the subconscious issues that kind of like indwell in us throughout our life. And a lot of us deal with it.
Yeah.
All of us deal with it. So it's really being able to speak up about how you feel, what's going on in your life, recognizing that you're not an island by yourself. No one is an island. No one is always there to talk through issues. And the disconnect that we now have as a society with modern technology and social media, it's now become a barrier between like interpersonal relationships. People no longer talk to each other.
No, everyone's on their phone.
Everyone's on technology.
And so when we completely detach from that, I think we'll be able to come back to who we used to be as a people.
Mm-hmm.
We talked, we spent time, it was love, you could feel the love.
Right.
And in Japanese asteroids, one, like the sentiment is love is the weapon.
Mm-hmm.
Love is that thing that'll make everything better.
Well, I want everyone out there to definitely come and see the project and support you ladies, but also where can they find you online to keep up with everything that you do?
PrinceTheater.org. The show is going to be at the Prince Theater on May 29th, and we have two showings, one at 3 and one at 7.
Awesome. And where can people follow you ladies specifically online?
So I am on all social media, Ontario, Kim Wilson, there's only one. Okay. I'm the only one.
You can find me on Facebook at Alexandra Rush, and you can find me Instagram, Determined Sound.
Awesome. Well, ladies, thank you so much for joining me. I cannot wait to see the show.
Thank you.
Well, that's all the time we have on My New Philly, where something is always new.
And everything is always Philly.
We have Journey's Journey. They're giving us the right kind of love. Indeed. And I'm not talking about the Journey song you're talking about.
It's not a small town girl living in a lonely world?
No, not that one. This one is actually...
She didn't take a midnight train?
No. But they are an organization that has a program that specifically helps children with mental and physical needs. I mean, it's such a great cause. This is why I love Philadelphia. You guys got to check this out.
I started Journey's Journey to help children and families like my daughter. There's only 5% of children that are like her that suffer from unique vision disabilities. We're having an event, a vendors expo at the Philly Recreational Center here in Philadelphia. We'll help raising and bringing awareness to children like Journey with these unique disabilities. We're going to have fun for all ages, for the whole entire family. Games, have live performances, DJ Heavenly as our DJ, the music, food, everything. We're going to auction WHYY membership packages, and we're also having giveaways from Pink Ice Cafe. If people are able to attend, they can easily donate at www.journeysjourney.info, where they can click the icon to donate. You can dial in $1, $5, $10, every dollar counts.
I just got to give a shout out to Journey's Journey. You guys are doing an amazing thing in the city. I mean, this is what we're here for, to cover things like this. So it's amazing. I'm all about covering news for people who are underrepresented and need that the most. So.
And if you want us to come down there and sing Journey's Don't Stop Believing,
just we're to down kinda, for that.
We'll do that. We'll do that. Well, to let everybody know also too, listen, Philly Lockbox, the real estate market is booming. We have Christina Hank. She's down at 1421 Colorado Street, about to show us this amazing, beautiful house.
It's gorgeous, and it's right in Point Breeze.
See it. Go see it. See it now.
Welcome back to this Lemeshevsky Real Estate Investments property, 1421 South Colorado Street here in Point Breeze, Philadelphia. I'm Christina Hink. We're here for Lockbox Philly. This place is gorgeous. I can't wait to show you the details. Remember last summer, I brought you guys here to this property while it was under construction. Now it's finished, it's gorgeous, it's got 3 bedrooms, 3 baths, and there's a lot of new construction properties in this neighborhood, but I want to show you why this one's the best. This house has multiple entertainment areas. When you first come in the front door, you see that there's a tile and gas fireplace. It's really great for a seating area on the great room main level. Down here, there's plenty of space. It's perfect for entertainment and hanging out with friends to watch TV. Master suite is really great. Obviously the bathroom is gorgeous. There's a ton of white on white tile with one bold strip in the shower. There's a soaking tub, space for his and hers with double vanities. I really like this big open window. This is a bonus space. I showed you this before when I came through and it was under construction. There was no flooring, there was no railing, and I just love this for a big open office. The owner of Lemeshevsky Real Estate Investments is super busy left and right doing real estate deals. If you want more information on how to partner with them or more information on this property, you can contact him here. That's all the time we have today for My New Philly, where something's always new and everything's always Philly.
Wow, the place she just showed us is goals. But so many places like that are coming, like blowing up in Philly.
Really,
like,
really.
Beautiful houses.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Well, guess what you have to do sometimes. For some people, guess what you have to do to get a house like that?
What?
You gotta go to college, right?
Yeah, well.
For some people.
For some people.
For some people, right? So Philly.
Yeah, because Philly does a lot of things.
Philly does a lot of things.
And maximum wages is going to be.
Terry Matthews from Maximum Wage actually sat down with Philadelphia College Prep Roundtable members, and they talked all about FAFSA, how your kids should be applying for colleges, some strategies and tactics with that. So check it out. College is right around the corner. You know, summertime, people trying to apply. So check out these tips.
Hello, everyone. You're watching Maximum Wage, and this is where we tell you in Philadelphia who's hiring and how you'll be better to get the job. I'm your host, Terry Matthews, and we have a special edition today. We're going to talk to you how you can get your loved one to college, and actually, how can you pay for it? So Nicole, you know, you're an author, and it sounds like you have this thing on lock. First of all, we need to know, what is FAFSA?
FAFSA is the free application for federal student aid. So everyone who plans on getting loans or financial aid from the government, they have to complete that application.
Okay, so I'm so glad you defined that, because I didn't know what that was about. Most parents don't, you know. In reference to some of the work that you do, how early should a person be preparing for their kid to go to college?
Well, when parents are looking at finances, of course, elementary is it, but actually to get the most out of their financial aid package is middle school. They want to, yes, middle school.
Middle school.
Yes, okay. They want to start looking at those high-level math classes and advanced classes. So when they get to high school, they'll have the advanced classes, which will boost their grade point average, and that's one of the key determinants to give financial aid.
That's important to know. So middle school parents out there, middle school, and Deneen, I know you deal a lot, too, also with high school students. Can you tell me, is financial aid provided every single year?
Yes, financial aid is provided every single year, as long as the student makes sure they apply for it and sign off on their promissory notes, and they have to do it every year. So you'll get an email about it. It might be mailed at home to mom and dad, but you have to stay on top and make sure that you sign that promissory note and keep on top so you can get your financial aid every year.
Well, I need FAFSA. Thank you. So Dustin, I know that you deal a lot at the community college, and usually in community college there are a lot of adults that are returning to school. So what are some of the issues that you'll see students facing when they're applying for financial aid in a community college setting?
With the Community College of Philadelphia, we do have a wide variety of students, from 18 to 65 and everything in between. So we see a lot of different issues, but I'd say one of the main things would be people waiting to the last minute. You know, adults who are very busy may think, oh, I can go enroll and do everything in one day. That's not the case with financial aid. With financial aid, you have to be very early and then stay on top of everything to make sure everything goes through. Okay. So that's when the issue is, just being on time with things.
People need to understand, is there an age limit with completing the FAFSA?
There's not. That's probably one of the biggest misconceptions when it comes to financial aid. People think, oh, this is only for high school students, or, you know, people who are just starting a school for the first time, and that's not true at all. We have a lot of students that are returning, getting back into college. We have a lot of students who might be in their 30s, 40s, or 50s who have never attempted, but that financial aid is always going to be there no matter what age you're at.
See, that's good. That's totally good to know. So in other words, I can come back to college, I can speak with you, and you can help me get financial aid. So tell me, there's a lot here when it comes to colleges and understanding the process. What I'm hearing all of you say is connect to a financial aid advisor. They're gonna really help you no matter what age you are, no matter what ethnicity you are. None of that actually matters. You just need to connect to somebody, right? How does College Prep Roundtable prepare people for their career and also their career in college?
Well, career in general, I've been with the College Prep Roundtable for over a decade, and they pretty much have helped me connect with all the Philadelphia guidance counselors in the city, different organizations and programs that work with inner city youth, and that has assisted me in recruiting students to my institutions. So they've been kind of like the key to the city for me.
I would say something very similar. As a young professional in the city, Philadelphia College Prep Roundtable really allowed me to network the people that I could then utilize to help those learners. Because the more people you know, the more resources I can then put other people in touch with, and that's a great thing that the network allowed me to really do.
The Philadelphia College Prep Roundtable has just helped me be able to meet, you know, fabulous people like Dustin and Deneen, and increase my network because I'm outside of Philadelphia. And I also still work with students during the day.
So college preparation is so important. This is a lot of information. Please be sure to check out their website, because that's all the time we have on Maximum Wage. Thank you for tuning in to My New Philly, where something's always new and everything is always Philly.
Wow, I wish I heard some of those tips when I was applying for college, because...
Yeah, I could have used some. I could probably still use some now.
Yeah, probably.
Rock out with it. So, Tiffany McLoy got a chance to sit down with Steel Pony while we were doing fitting room.
Steel Pony?
Yeah, Steel Pony. She got a chance to check out Steel Pony and all their amazing pieces and how they come up with some of their amazing pieces.
Well, let's see it out.
Fitting room, let's go check it out.
Welcome to the fitting room, where trend, style, and fashion in Philadelphia are always our focus. I'm your host, Tiffany B, and I am so tired of having to carry my gym bag all the way to the gym. I need something that's easily transferable from day to night. So I did a little research, and I found the Steel Pony. So let's go into a little bit of shopping and take a look at all the latest trends on athleisure wear.
Is a concept of clothing that you can wear from
gym all the way to dinner. Something like this, the legging, that has, it's a very cool double dye. And with the tank, and this little shrug is great because if it's cold out, or when the beginning of yoga, it's cold. So another option is to have a jacket like this, that you can, I mean, this thing, you could just roll in a ball and throw it in your bag, and when you take it out, it's perfect.
I'm ready to try some things on. Let's grab a couple of pieces.
Okay, great. Let's go. How do I look?
Wow, don't you look awesome in that?
I love this. This is super, super comfortable.
So I call that my Danny yoga pant, and it is made of 100% cotton, and it has that cotton lycra band, which is, I put that on a lot of things because it's really great. It's a great tucker. You can also wrap it around to the back and tie it, and have another, so you have another way of wearing it.
And I was really digging this jacket. I love the fact that it's like tie-dye.
So it's not tie-dye.
Oh, it's not tie-dye.
Yeah, I call this technique hand-dyed.
What is that?
Hand-dyed is basically just dyeing with one color. It's like batch dyed, so I put it in with other things, and it just comes out however it does. See, and the, like,
beautiful.
See the difference of all the variation on it? So each piece is a one of a kind.
Right, there's never two that are the same.
Never.
All of this is done here?
Yes, we do all the dyeing here. We do most of the sewing here, and I do all the designing here.
Bag it up.
Okay.
I'm taking it.
All right. It's yours.
So I got my athleisure wear, and I am so excited. That's all the time we have here at MyNewPhilly.com, where something's always new
and everything's always Philly.
I got to head to Steel Pony and have her dress me up because those outfits were fleek.
Oh, indeed.
Is it weird that I say fleek? Do you guys know what fleek means?
I don't. I don't really know. And I try not to use anything that I can't define. So.
All right. Well, I can't define fleek either. So I'm just word spitting different things.
You know what I can define, though?
What?
Amazing. And that's what this next piece is. Listen, what? Fun Sponge Cat Cat.
Oh.
Our host Cat Cat. Amazing Cat Cat. He got a chance to check out Legoland Discovery Center.
Legoland.
Oh, man. It's amazing. And let me see if you guys can catch this. Cat Cat spits out a little fun fact about
a bunch of them, probably. Knowing Cat Cat.
About something going on in Legoland and one of their displays and a little key things you might not pick up on. So see if you can guess what this is. See if you can catch on to what it is. If you don't worry.
We'll tell you later.
We'll let you know.
Hey, it's a brand new day. I'm your host, Cat Cat with MyNewPhilly.com, and it's time for the Fun Sponge. Today we're at Legoland Adventure Center in Plymouth Meeting, soaking up all the fun. Come along, guys. Hey, look, it's a Lego man. Woo! So right now, I'm walking into Miniland. And the great part about Miniland is our city. Here's Reading Terminal. Here's the Art Museum. And right here, we have one of my personal favorites, the Kimmel Center. And look, we have our very own substance station. Fun fact about this, guys, this whole thing was made with over 1 million bricks. And if you look at the Lego people, none of them look the same. The Lego people must have did a really hard job putting all these people together. I know you guys recognize this stadium. It's the Link, home of the Philadelphia Eagles. Hey guys, so right now I'm here with Blaine from marketing. So Blaine, what is Legoland Discovery Center all about?
Legoland Discovery Center is all about Lego fun. So we are designed for families. They can come in, they can ride our Imagination Express, they can check out our 4D cinema. We also have 10 separately themed Lego play zones that are all about building with Lego bricks.
That is so cool. Could you tell me what those 10 play zones are?
Absolutely. So we have a build and test zone for you to build your own car and race it down a ramp. We have a Duplo Park, which is specifically for the younger kids. We have our Pirate Adventure Island here, which is a soft play area.
Oh, that's so cool. I was playing in that.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. It's actually my favorite part of the attraction, too. We have earthquake tables. You can build a building as tall as you possibly can and see if you can knock it down. We have Lego Friends. We have a Ninjago training camp. The list goes on and on. There's a lot to do.
That is so cool. And is Legoland appropriate for the whole family?
Absolutely. Legoland Discovery Center is designed for families, so it's absolutely perfect.
So guys, as you heard, you have to come down here. It's in a Plymouth Meeting Mall, and the opening date is April 6th. This was so fun, I have to ride it again. That's all the time we had on MyMePhilly.com, where something's always new and everything's always silly.
I want to go there. So you have to take me there.
Did you see what the fun fact was? Did y'all see what the fun fact was?
What was the fun fact? You can tell them anyways.
All right, so check this out. The fun fact is, in the replica of the city, each individual person is not duplicated. So
Everyone's unique in Lego form,
do you understand how like crazy that is?
Yeah.
Like that, how many Lego pieces can you find where you don't put together the same people?
I'm a grown adult and I still want to go. Only if Baby the Host goes with me. So.
Well, we definitely. You want to go to Legoland? Okay, so let's see.
We got to go to Legoland.
So we had, let me see, Legoland.
We have Legoland. We have everything.
Gayborhood.
Yeah.
Gayborhood. We got
35 years of service by the Gay Men's Chorus.
Journey. We got to check them out.
Not the singing journey that you're thinking about. So many things.
But don't stop believing. No matter what. Don't stop believing. What else did we get? 421?
Yes. 1421.
Colorado Street. Real estate is going crazy.
Steel Pony. Get your fashion there. We always provide a diverse array of segments just for you guys. Like always, but we gotta go hang out with her and pick our date for when we're going to Legoland. So
we're gonna do
that's all the time we have here today.
Baby the Host, Legoland. Say yay, Legoland.
Yay, Legoland.
There we go.
Oh my gosh, she's so cute. I'm in love.
Make your cute face, surprise face. There we go. So this is all the time we have here on The Ben Show and My New Philly. Make sure you check us out at www.mynewphilly.com.
And follow us on social media at My New Philly on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
And
that's all the time.
That's all the time we have. This is My New Philly, where something's always new.
And everything's always Philly.
Surprise face.
MyNewPhilly.com highlights the people, places, and events that make Philadelphia the best place to live, work, play, and visit.
And we are here at the Philadelphia Style Best of Style 2016.
Of course. I mean, I have a network that's launching probably late February, early March, called the Laugh Out Loud Network. And that's what the network is about. It's about finding the next thing, the next guy, the next girl, that next piece of comedic talent, that next great content creator. You know, eventually I want to compete with the hugest brands in the world, but you start off small.
I mean, can you see Ben Franklin Bridge from here? It looks so small from up here.
Ben Franklin, look at William Penn. City Hall is still standing strong. Wow.
Convention center right over there. My music's so
loud. Yo, what's up? I'm Motor Mike, aka Mike Kern. I'm here with the Philly Tour Hub and some members of My New Philly crew.
Woo!
Okay, we got hands off from Ben here. Ben, how about you tell us a bit about what's going on?
I bring local people on this tour, and they haven't been to half these places. We go down to the Italian Market, Penn's Landing, get down into South Philly, some of the residential areas, come up through the historic district, Society Hill, up past Independence Hall. It's a really awesome tour.
So this restaurant definitely stands out amongst the Philly food scene. This is Kensington Quarters.
Hey, welcome to Lockbox Philly. I'm Christina Hink, and we're here. Welcome to the master bedroom. This house is 3-bedroom, 2.5-bath. For this room, I really think the bed goes here.
That's right, indoor skydiving. Hey, it's a brand new day.
I'm your host, Cat Cat, with MindyPhilly.com, and it's time for the Fun Sponge. Today we're at I Fly and King of Prussia soaking up all the fun. Come along, guys.
I believe I can fly.